Hi everybody, it's Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa. Welcome to the live, fully live painting tutorial. On the mic today is my husband, John.
Hey guys.
He does a very important function. He follows me around with camera so you can see what the heck I'm doing, and he reads the comments. That's about to get really important for you guys here on the live. If you're coming on the replay, I hope the people here for you, representing you on the live, do a good job representing you well, because I want to ask our community something. Now, as you know, in the iCard, this painting is already available to paint, exactly as you see it here.
Yes.
Just straight up the lesson in some nice music, just that. But,
yeah.
But, and I want you to ponder this because you're going to have to convince John, I was thinking it might be fun on the live to kick it up a notch.
What does that even mean?
That means I was noticing, I thought it might be kind of fun because we haven't done it yet to do a very complicated, wonderful oak tree. Maybe okay. Up our tree game a little bit. Now, I'm perfectly happy to go through exactly the ways that we have it designed here and to add a little black light ghost. And if that's what we want to do, that's what we're going to do. But if you guys want to, we can kick it up a notch and I can show you some extra tree skills.
Ooh.
You know, because you showed up live. And people who show up live get extra
stuff.
Oh,
well, I just looked over there and then there's this stream of, yes, let's kick it up a notch. I just got all my buttons pushed and like.
So if you're here on the replay, they've decided to kick it up a notch. Better check the thumbnail or skip to the end to see what painting we actually end up doing.
Well, I see.
That's my, just go to the end and be like, oh yeah, and then go back and then do the whole thing. Or I'll always put it up on the thumbnail.
Ooh. Well, there is an eruption in here of yes, yes, yes. Please,
all right.
As a matter of fact, I'll just show you if you can look over there.
Oh yeah.
Everybody was just like, oh, yeah.
Oh, let's
ready
treat
to go.
Up. Now that's going to make it a horizontal instead of a vertical. Is that cool with everybody?
Okay.
Well, because the tree's kind of low and all right. So I'll explain to you why I would change this from a vertical to a horizontal. If you look at the profile of this tree, it's got this very low profile, and this will look better spaced in this canvas for our design.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm doing it that way. And I'm
all
not,
right.
We'll still do blacklight ghosties. We might even drop some rooties down. I just kind of wanted to take this idea and explore it a little bit further. I also have to do some wishes today.
Now, we have a, let's see here. We have a, this is, we have a hard stop today though.
Hmm.
We only have about an hour and 45 minutes today.
I think I can do this an hour and 45.
You think you can do this an hour and 45?
I think I can. If we just get busy painting.
All right. What are you doing with your brush other
oh,
than
no.
abusing it?
Abusing my brush. Well, I just want you to know that we have some wishes on the canvas.
Okay, so let's talk about our wishes.
All right. D, her foot needs some healing, and it would be very great if it could go flat.
Uh-huh.
She's in a healing process, and that's her last barrier to being much, much better. And Courtney needs some relief in her throat, and we've had three about migraines. So right now I'm just going to put a wish up here that those suffering with migraines get relief from that.
Yeah, that's a good wish.
So I like that. And then also that all the kids do good in school, because this is a go back to school painting.
Yeah. And can we throw another wish in there for it?
Yeah, it's alive. We can wishy wish as much as we wish to wishy wish.
Fish. Can we put a little wish for a pet Merlin?
Yes. What does pet Merlin need?
Well wishes. And then I have another one here. Hold on a second. For Katie's mom, who's having a bad fight with vertigo. Her name's Karen.
Well, yeah, I know. Katie's mom is really going through it. Vertigo is rough.
Yeah.
I've had that a couple times in my life. That's how I realized I was allergic to certain propellants.
Yeah.
So they give me vertigo, which I do not like.
Yeah, and definitely, yeah, there's a lot of wishes for the pets out there. So it seems like there's a bunch of pets going through that.
Well, there's a wonderful pet here, so let's just wish angels to surround and light and love around our pets and companions, you know, that take care of us and keep us safe and loved.
And we'll put a wish for Kim and Stephanie on there as well. They have some.
I'm using watercolor pencils, so this is going to disappear into my paint, theoretically. I'm also using a board today.
Mm-hmm.
16 by 20 board instead of a canvas, mostly because I ran out of canvas and I didn't know it till right before the lesson.
I mean, I'm going to say thanks.
I've been doing a lot of painting this week, like a lot.
Oh, yeah, I know.
What are you going
to
say?
I was going to say thank you so much to all of our light keepers out there. We have so many requests coming in right now, so many wishes coming in. And oh my gosh, so this is a really nice one. Nipsey says, wish request, I donated my kidney. Please wish it continues to work well through its new home body. Absolutely.
Oh, that you're such a light keeper.
Holy cow. That's awesome. Thank you, Nipsey. That was like, that. I can't imagine a nicer gift that you could give.
That's incredible. I know you changed somebody's life in an amazing and real way.
Yeah.
You guys are incredible. You're an incredible community.
So it just sort of blew me away there while I was trying to say thank you to all the light keepers out there who are catching all of the wishes that we're not. Almost didn't catch that one from Nipsey, which is just sort of like, thank you guys. There's so many coming in. And you know, Lucy, welcome. And there's lots of new people here that are joining us for the first time. But thank you guys all for joining us.
You're here for the first time. Yeah, there's a lot of talking. No point in leaving a comment about it later. We know.
Yeah, and we've got like over 150, 160
go
people
go see the
here.
iCard just, for the no-talkie lesson.
Yeah, it's just incredible, everybody. Thank you so much for coming. I'll let Cinnamon get back to the painting. But thank you guys for catching those wishes.
So today I have titanium whiteout, Mars black, phthalo blue, and I'm also using acrylic glazing liquid gloss. Mm-hmm. By Golden. This comes whenever you see where it says gloss, it means that there's other finishes that you can find. I like that one because it allows me to glaze and it slows down the drying time on my paint, which does improve the blendability of my paint. And that makes a big difference because the conditions in my studio are very hot and dry. Mm. Dry being the operative word.
So while you're doing this, there's a lot of people and meetings and cheering up in here.
All right, so let's cheer it up.
We're
let's get
some
into
up cheering.
It. So, in a weird way, we're going to cheer it up by glooming it out. So, let's gloomy up this day.
How are we going to do that?
We're going to take a little of our phthalo blue over to our black. This is called toning your black.
Okay.
And we're going to add a lot of white. I'm going to get a little glazing. Look at that gloopy mess I have on my brush.
What are you going to do with that?
And I'm going to just add a diagonal from the upper left towards the lower right. Kind of brush in this windy, blustery, rainy day.
Huh.
Now I'm on this board, and is it resisting me? It says
is
no.
Is it fighting you?
Yeah. I should have rinsed it or somethinged it first. But then I didn't know I was painting on it, so.
So all of those, all of you who are joining us today, oh my gosh, I just looked over and there's over 213
people,
213 people
have been kidnapped on a tree quest. They didn't even know that they were on.
So we're going to, you know.
Welcome to the adventure.
We're going to make sure that everybody stays cheery and upbeat here today because we need some. It seems like everybody needs a little bit of that on these gloomy, rainy days. So
sometimes gloomy days are wonderful. They remind us of how much we love the sun.
And, you know, if you guys don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and hit that like button because we're going to, as soon as we hit 300, we're going to put on some dance music, get everyone dancing a little bit, make Sherpa dance.
So I'm just going to let you know, I'm on this Artist Loft canvas board.
How's that working?
And this is a weirder, it's different texture than the canvases itself.
I'm going to zoom into that because you can see
it's
kind of breaking
up a little
bit. It's
just a weird texture, so it's definitely a different experience. And I'm dealing with it on the fly here because I like to paint live. Because what could possibly go wrong that way?
It's just paint?
It's just paint. It really is. This is what I know. Even if I get completely lost, other than kidnapping you into whatever my lost moment is, it's still just paint.
Now, you're using a really big brush.
I'm using a number 12 bright. I could probably use a bigger brush for this, but I got a number 12 bright out. And I'm going to do the whole canvas in this diagonal. But I'm not, like, worrying about that it's all exactly the same tone.
Okay.
That's not my concern right now.
Why is that? Why aren't you worried about
the... Because the sky should be a bunch of different tones, and this piece is a little bit decorative. So having some of that varying up actually works in this piece's favor for it to be emotional. This is more of an emotional piece than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
This was really about what came from this is a couple of things. When I designed this, I was thinking about how much I miss my kids when they go to school and how at the end of summer you can see them sort of amp up their commitment to play and joy because they know that time is coming to an end and they want to go out even on the rough days, mm-hmm. even on the rainy days and play.
Now there's some funny stuff going on. We have a couple of people in our
in our community here in Houston area, and they mm-hmm. have they're watching us on their TV right now.
You know what? I'm missing my own premiere to be with you guys. I'm missing my own premiere on public access television to be with y'all. So if you're watching it, let us know if it's good.
Yeah.
Because we don't know, and we won't get to see it.
We got to, I mean, like, we were there when we filmed it, so.
That's right. We were there for filming it, but it's not the same as, like, sitting down with, we're going to try Tuesday to sit down with some popcorn and watch it.
Yeah. Because we don't film on Tuesdays.
No, we do film on Tuesdays, sweetheart.
I know.
Oh. But it's later. Right now, we're just working around that YouTube schedule. So I signed us up for some more classes. By the way, as I announced to you, live paint.
What did you do?
I signed us up for some more live classes.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
What?
I think that's
one step. Wait, what?
Yeah.
What classes?
It's another one of their boot camps.
Oh, cool.
But they seem to have expanded it, so I just wanted to see what it was. You know, just in case it's good. It seems to be all Wednesday anyways.
A lot of people asked me if I was going to DVR the show. And I
it
was like,
"Wouldn't let me. I don't even have it."
Well, see, the irony though of that for me was kind of like, I'm going to record my show that I aired on public television. I don't know. It seemed like I should do it, but I already have it, so I don't know.
So y'all are used to me. You can see I'm just doing my diagonal brushstroke here. I'm just filling in this space. It's definitely different when you paint on these boards. They have a lot less spring, so that gives you a different result that you might not be familiar with that could be interesting to you. So many quests to do. Canvas quests, easel quests, quest on the color white. I feel like, you know, the course is definitely going to have to go past a year because I just keep coming up with new stuff we got
to
do.
But we may have to do some new fruit.
Yeah, we're going to do some new fruit.
We may have to...
The new fruit. 2017 bigger quest. The new fruit. Oh my gosh, why is that so funny to me?
I don't know.
You guys are at home are like, it's not that funny, guys. Stop. But we feel like it's funny. But then we're big, silly goofs.
So if you're here going, oh my gosh, would they just stop talking? There's an iCard. And in that iCard is a much more discreet lesson.
Yeah.
Much more to the point. Just the facts, as one might say.
Just the facts. And I know for some, the music has been frustrating. And we're really, just so you understand like where it's coming from, we actually have a reason why we have to do that music.
Yes. Yes. So we live in a suburban area, really close to Intercontinental Airport, with children and trucks and buses and kids who play loud music that roll by and trip content ID systems and children who play video games with
The trip content. Can you tell this has happened to us before?
Ringtones that go off and trip content ID systems. See, there's Spider, right? Walking up right now.
With Skylander Boy and Girl, which would totally trip the content ID system.
So what we have to do... So what we have to do is run a little bit of background music that we pay license for. And that way, it covers up any other music that might be ambient in the background. And we have
that, it's not that we're not listening to you guys or we don't have sympathy for everyone's different experience. I know the lion's share of you really enjoy the music, but for the people who are generally, you know, in our community who are like, this is frustrating for me, that's why it's there. And we're just really stuck with it. We did try to, the ASMR video, we were able to not put it on there.
We were in a studio.
We were in a studio, though.
Yeah.
So that was super helpful.
Yeah, but here it's like, we have really good mics. And it's very noisy.
Very.
Very noisy.
Very.
As a matter of fact, we normally leave the air conditioner on just for some background hiss because it's also good at covering things up. And I can cancel that out easier than I can other noise.
It's so true.
So.
Okay.
So talk about your blending medium.
I'm now nervous about the fruits of my decision.
Oh, no.
I can't get up. Okay, it's fine.
Show me what tell me
what. So what I've got here is my very favorite cloud brush. And what makes this a good cloud brush is it's a very robust, you can see that round. It is a soft round. It's not a sharp detail point. It has this nice sort of rounded soft edge here.
Yeah.
It's very thick, and these are very short bristles. Most of the brushes, and these are bristles, not filaments, which means they're like from a, like a hog or something. Most of these out there in the world will want to make these really long, but you want the shortest ones that you can find in the store, or you can do a destroyed, you may have one of these in your house, a destroyed fluffy brush, or if you're really stuck and you don't have any of those, a stiff deerfoot stippler. So, but this is my go-to, and I really like this. I'm going to load no water on my brush. I'm going to load a little paint and my glazing medium, and I'm going to load that up on my brush, and I'm going to come in my upper right, and I'm going to do my little circles that I like to do for my clouds. And how I do this is I plant my brush so that it's kind of got this angle. That's why the deerfoot stippler works. And I make a little circles, and I just try to dance up and down this cloud shape. And what's wonderful, if you have the glazing liquid...
Does that round have a number on it?
No, man, that round has nothing left on it.
Okay.
And I don't even, I'm not even sure they make this brush anymore. This wasn't an expensive brush. The best brushes are not necessarily expensive. It's about knowing what you're trying to find in your brush.
Gotcha. You know?
And then finding, wherever you are at, finding a brush that fits those qualifications. Now, another thing I'm doing here, and we've talked about this before on our cloud quest, but this is sort of a technique cloud, but I'm making sure that I go back and forth sort of on the level at the bottom. I put this level bottom on my cloud. And that helps it feel a little more like a cloud.
Huh.
I'm going to come up here and do the same thing. So the glazing liquid is helping me, but you could do this just with your dry brush over dry paint and get a great effect too. The big thing is to be like, try not to clone your patterns. Keep your pressure very light and your circles small. And think about breaking that up. Think about clouds. If you need to look at some clouds to get some ideas of the types of shapes that they make, that's really helpful. And it's never a bad idea if you're having trouble visualizing something in your head to just use your phone, search it, and get a photo reference.
Now, I see in here that Mandy was just asking about...
Hi, Mandy.
She was asking the community about buying used brushes. And I know that you had talked about that recently. Did you have some thoughts maybe?
Yeah, I do. I think it's perfectly fine. If you know that the brush, what the brushes were used for, were they used for acrylic or oils, right? And if you know what you're looking for in brushes, you could buy used brushes. Some people really care for their brushes.
Now,
or if you're really good at restoring brushes, you could buy used brushes. I know people who've done it.
And you'd said that that was an important thing is making sure that they acrylic or oil.
Yeah, because oil prevents the acrylic from binding and drawing and doing what it needs to do. You never want to mix those two mediums.
Gotcha.
So that's why. It's important just to make sure that your brushes are clean and free of all of those products.
Cool. Okay.
So you can see how the paint being picked up from underneath the white is actually helping create these kind of fun, wonderful little clouds.
Hmm.
And I like that. Do we have any cloud questions as we're going along?
Well, actually, there's a lot of really good questions. Like DJ Divine was just asking.
Hi, DJ Divine.
She's asking about what recommended size brushes and things.
We have a video on that.
You know what? I will see if we can. You know what? Flame just said that. She was just like, we have a whole quest on that. So hopefully we'll see if we can. And there it is.
Yeah,
the
we tried to do an updated studio list because I had done one at the beginning when I first started out.
I'm going to first give a real quick thanks. Big quick thanks to Flame, who's just like always got those links right there for you guys. She really tries to help out and make sure you guys can help find that stuff. So I appreciate that.
I do. I'm putting a little cloud here, even though I know I'm going to have a lot of tree here, just so my sky stays interesting and not boring.
Yep.
And doesn't look like, you know, a Tex Avery cartoon where my clouds are too orderly. I want them there, but I don't want them too orderly, is what I'm looking for. Now, I'm going to have to dry this to do the next part. So, sippy. Gotta hydrate.
And I'm gonna take this time while you got that straw there. There are over 250 people here in the room. Thank you guys for coming. Please,
hope you
please,
wanted
please.
A kicked up tree.
Yes, please.
If you just showed up, everybody voted to make the tree more complicated.
I know. And that's why Cinnamon's like, oh my gosh. But post your pictures up on Facebook. I've been going through liking and seeing all of them up there. I love seeing all those. And,
yeah.
There's been
while
so
John's
many
talking,
good ones.
I'm going to hair dry.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. Please like, comment, subscribe, and share. If you have some friends that you would like to have join you out here in the live, please share with them because we love having more people out here. It's so much fun. We've got over 250 people now, and we've got over 160 likes. So everybody, don't forget to hit the thumbs up because that's a great way that you can show YouTube. You guys like what you see here. And as soon as we get to 300 likes or 300 people in the room, we are Sherpa, and we do the We Are Sherpa dance. And we celebrate as much as we can. So, I don't know. It's fun. If you haven't been here to the channel, this is kind of what we do. And when I run out of things to say, I just babble on incessantly and people do stuff. Yeah. I'm supposed to answer questions. Oh my gosh, I'm all alone. Request. Oh, finally. And Cinnamon's over telling me that I'm fine. And I, yeah. Oh, there's... I gotta have something. Thank you guys for coming and being here. I think I've said that, right? So Bonnie was asking about the games. There you go, something I'm gonna ask her. I have them all. They're all going out here. A bunch of them were they were back ordered. The shipping was slow, but we had them all packaged up and their goal and they've been
I've
going
gotta
out.
Sign them all now.
Not all of them. There's a bunch that have to be signed though. Just that last batch to be packed.
It would be easier for you to write us and say, don't sign mine. To know who's like, I'm opening them and signing them.
That's so true. So now everyone's coming up with the, oh, you're just so alone out there.
I'm so alone.
They're giving me solidarity support.
Oh. All right. So I'm going to pull out just my phthalo blue. Right? Just my phthalo blue. And again, remember, don't let glazing medium be the thing that stops you from this or you know, if you're using a retarder. I love that Grubbacher retarder.
Hi, Tris.
You know, don't let it stop you. It's just a product. It's just a tool. Water works, too. I'm going to make a landscape.
Now, what is the blending medium you're using there?
I'm using the Golden Acrylic Liquid Glazing Medium by Golden. And it's different than a Liquitex, which everybody can easily get. But the thing about the Liquitex is it's designed to dry very quickly. Uh-huh. Which is awesome when you want that. If you wanted a glaze that dried quickly so you could work fast, fantastic product. But if you want a glaze that also slows down the drying of your paint, so far Golden is the only one I found that does both things.
Interesting.
And it's been a journey to find it. It's been a journey. I'm going to make a little landscape here. So I'm going to start my world. I'm going to go, my world starts over here. And then I'm going to make... not perfectly even ground because the ground is not even, right? So I'm going to make sure that there's hills and bumps and sort of personality on this. And then, and this is really a fun part, I'm going to pull down, and I want to be in John's way so you can up close, I'm going to plant my brush and just pull down very soft pressure this landscape a little bit. This is not dissimilar to what we have to do for the Aurora Borealis when we're trying to make it. Because we want this to be very... actually, it's where I got the idea. It has to be very uneven.
Mm-hmm.
You want it to look like torn earth, almost. That's what's fun.
Cool.
Oak trees are challenging for people.
No.
I feel like I can explain it.
Can you use the
I
same...
I may be mad, though. I might be crazy. I might be crazy.
Can you use the same brushes for watercolor and acrylic?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
Okay.
You don't want to use acrylic in your watercolor brushes. It ruins them.
Oh. What about using watercolor on your acrylic brushes?
Yeah, that's fine. You know.
Because they're built like tanks?
Yeah. Well, because they've already been damaged. They may not carry the paint as well. I mean, I certainly do it. Multimedia artists certainly do it. But I know that if you have a really good watercolor brush, don't put any acrylic paint or oil in it ever.
Gotcha. Because it takes on water differently than...
yeah, these are weirdly sourced, brushed animals where their longest hairs are collected. I don't know. It's a whole story.
So if I...
there's a reason why they can get to be hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars.
If I understand it correctly, oftentimes watercolor brushes have bristles.
Nope. They have hair.
I thought that's what hair was.
No, bristles are from hogs.
Ah, that's what it was. Bristles versus hair versus filaments.
Yes.
That's there's so much
the
to
convo
know.
To talk. I know that's why people get so frustrated in the art store. It's not that it's necessarily hard to paint. It's that it's just frustrating in the art store.
It's just there's so
and
much.
And there's
to
always
know.
That kid that's gone catatonic who's supposed to be there to help you who is in art school. Who knows what he's got going on? We don't know. It's always something. It's always something, and usually a lot of strong and unfounded art opinions.
Yes.
Just saying. It's a journey.
So let me ask here. Where did that question go? How hard was your touch on those canvases, on the canvas clouds?
My touch was quite soft.
For making those the clouds there?
Clouds are always a soft touch.
Gotcha.
Clouds are always going to be a soft pressure.
Cheryl came in late today.
Hi, Cheryl.
Hopefully she brought the donuts.
Did she bring the donuts? Does she know why things have changed? Cheryl, they change things.
We now require you to bring donuts if you show up.
We're now painting a harder tree if you wanted the easier treats in the iCard. I just feel like, you know, if you come to the live, you should get something special, though. Because you are special. You came to a live, so you're special.
Yeah.
You should get something.
A party?
That other people aren't getting. I'm trying to kind of break up my landscape here a little more unevenly. Think about my design a little bit. I want clean lines here at the top, rough lines at the bottom. Cool, right?
Yeah.
All right. Let that dry for a minute. Get a small brush out that we have some control over. I'm going to think a number 4 bright right here. And we're going to start our oak tree. Now, after this is all over, I'll be sure and post this painting on Pinterest. And I know I've got about 1,000 traceables to catch up on, so I'll definitely be working on that as well.
My favorite YouTuber, Todd Graham, is here.
Hi, Todd Graham, your favorite YouTuber. Are you watching for all the other YouTubers?
Like,
when Steve French is here, you never know it's him, and he's a YouTuber.
I watch all Todd's videos, though.
That's true.
I'm a big Todd fan.
Chris plays games. All right, I'm gonna tell everybody how to do this tree. Hi, Todd.
It's not that I don't like everybody else. I just have my favorites.
Okay, so the base of the oaks grow slowly. The other thing oaks are is kind of bent and interesting and crookedy. So first thing that I'm going to do is go up just a couple of inches and put in this quite sturdy little trunk. Just paint that in because it's all got to start here. You gotta start with your trunk. I'm going to just go right to the ground. Even though it's going to get weird in a minute, I just want to have this base, this building block, this first Lego to build from.
Okay.
This is about, it's over an inch wide, maybe an inch and a quarter. And if you'll notice, it's not perfectly straight. I've got quite a lot of personality happening here. And we're going to have to use several brushes. We're going to use some detail brushes.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to talk about how do we get these branches in and have them look like themselves. So the first thing that will happen on oaks is they often have a pretty large branch split. And we all know on trees, they've got to be the thickest at the ground, and then every branch coming out is getting subsequently skinnier. Branch clinic. It's on now. So.
And you were like, let's just dive in and do an easy tree.
Well, we have that on this one. iCard. Easy tree is at the iCard. But this is worth learning. This may be a terrible idea, and you guys may be like, let's never deviate again. So I'm going to come up about an inch to the right. And then I'm going to do something interesting. I'm going to curve this branch down quite definitively. And as I'm brushing it out, it's getting skinnier and skinnier. Right? I want it to be skinnier and skinnier. Because oak trees have lots of turns and curves and nodules. And you really, if you want your painting to feel more like an oak, there it went up. You've got to kind of be willing. Whoa, look, it did a little zigzag. To really, really work out some of those nodules. So we've got it going there. And I'm going to finish that out actually with even smaller brushes.
All right.
I'm just building some architecture here.
It just looks like a squiggly line.
Yeah, I'm going to make another one right here coming right off here. It's going to go up and squiggle up like this direction.
Okay.
It will have some other refining. Yeah.
All
right. Yeah, we're doing this, right?
This seems like we're out on a limb here.
We're. Oh, I love you. All right. Sweetie, hang in with me. We got this.
Okay.
We got this. Believe in the tree. Believe in your tree. Because you're gonna come up with this branch. Come up. And then you're going to go down. And then it's going to come up over here. And then, oh, it's going to go up. Oh, it's so crazy. Look how crazy that branch is.
I mean, like, I've seen you. Whoop, wrong thing. That was not supposed to be there.
What was it? Did you turn off the broadcast?
No, I just pushed the button where it was like it showed my little timer running.
All right, so we've got this. We've got time for a tree.
Oh, yeah.
Be calling people, we won't make it to lunch today. We're still teaching this oak tree. Weird YouTube excuses. Spider.
What are you doing, buddy? It's all sorts of things creeping in here today.
All right. And... all right, so I've got that. I'm just going to let that taper there. So now we've got this Y.
Uh-huh.
But it's starting to create the personality of our tree.
Uh-huh.
And that's what we're trying to put in, is this architecture of which we're going to build this wild, fantastical tree on.
Okay.
Now, things I want you to notice, my branches are quite long.
Yes.
And very crookedy. So that's a goal. Try to get an oak tree picture that you like to reference. Like, actually print one out, a silhouette, like oak silhouettes, anything. Because a really good search is oaks at sunset. Because it'll show the bones of the tree. So I'm coming out between this nodule, and I'm going to say this part of the tree is going up, but it's going to go wildly back. We got to take this little dude a bunch of different places, because that's what oaks do. They go a bunch of different places. They're really fun to paint.
Hmm. Now, there was, Carrie was asking.
There we go. Look at that. That's some bones there.
That's all right. I mean, they're willing to sit out here on a limb with you. So, Carrie was asking.
I'm thinning some paint here because I want more fluidity, and I can't switch to carbon black because I'm using Mars, and carbon and Mars have two different looks and finishes.
Okay.
And I'm trying to improve the fluidity or flow of my paint so that this part gets easier. There we go. Ah, so crookedy. I'm going to add another little crookedy little.
So
bit here.
There's a couple things here. So one is, Carrie wanted to know, is there an easy way to use your tutorials with oil paint? Because she has a bunch of oil paint.
Well, here's the issue with the oil paints. A lot of what's happening here is dependent on the layer underneath being dry. This is why acrylic artists and oil artists sometimes have trouble changing from one practice to the other practice, is because oil doesn't dry very quickly, as you know. And for acrylic, you're letting a layer dry, and then you're putting another layer on top of it and letting it dry and putting another layer on top of it. It's just recently with mediums that we're even doing wet into wet work. So the trick is like, if I'm letting something dry, you've got to make sure it dries on yours too, so it's not coming up through. Like, it'd be very tough to do this black tree over this background here in oil, because if the oil wasn't dry, it would just be a gray tree. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm going to switch to smaller brush even. Getting ever smaller and smaller. That's what I'm doing.
Crazy.
I'm looking for my weird little shader. I like, I love my shaders. There's a brush called a shader, and they're on the short-handled Simply Simmons, and I've got a 6 and a 2 here, and I love these for trees.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to do those for small, fiddly little branches. I'm going to make sure I mist my paint before it skins over. Well, that's not even working today.
Where are you going?
I don't know. My mister is not a mister anymore. It's a squirter, which is not ideal. It's not ideal, but you know what? You just work with it.
I think Mark and Stephanie are watching us from their campsite.
I think they do that. They've got some sort of like connectivity.
Don't they?
So now I have to start building these fantastical little branches that make up an oak tree. And it's about having them wander around. So with oak trees, your goals are to make sure that there's enough branches.
Okay.
For them to look like an oak, you've got to leave room for the birds to fly through and the squirrels to live in.
What brush is that you're using?
I am using the number 6 short-handled shader by Simply Simmons. It's just a shader. It's a small detail shader.
Okay. And there's lots of people saying, thank you, thank you, thank you. They love you.
Oh, I appreciate it. Just thank you so much. Thank you so much for being brave and going for the crazy tree. Because there's a lot going on here. There is.
Let's see here. And
we got this little crazy little branch is going to come down here, right? This is a hard like little practicey thing.
Nia has a message she wants me to pass on there to you. I'm going to read it. So actually,
hi, Nia.
I'll see if I can even get this over for you to see real quick. It says, and you don't get to see these very often, so I'm just going to slide it over there. But it, right,
I can't read that small font when it's in that screen.
Oh, okay.
I don't have my loopies.
You don't have your loops on, huh? So it says, hello, I'm from India, and you're my first tutor. I love your work, and I have learned to paint from you. Thank you so much, and I hope that John will pass this message on.
Thank you, Nia. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Yeah. I very much enjoy getting to be your instructor. It's my pleasure. It's an honor.
And we'd love to see you guys' paintings, so definitely post those up. Love to see that.
So I'm going to create another little branch that maybe wanders around here. The thing about oaks is you want to give them lots of joints, nodules, little cracks where they go different directions. And you've got to get the fiddly bit, little tiny, wickety little branches in too, is what it is about oak trees. So besides their kind of little robust little shape that they do, you're really committed to a bunch of these little kind of wandering little branches that you'll be endlessly putting in smaller and smaller brushes, which is why a lot of people kind of go, oh, I'm just not good at trees. All that happened is they just gave up on their little oak too soon. You just gotta hang in, man. Gotta hang in. And here's the deal. I'm building a lot of architecture that when I put the foliage on is gonna go away. You guys may not want to put the foliage on. You may be like, my tree needs to be this, because oaks will drop their leaves. So your tree could be just further in the season. It's okay to also make sure that you do like maybe broken joints coming off the tree. Oaks are brittle and their branches do break quite often. They're mighty, but they're not flexible. I'm kind of enjoying this little tree here, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are we glad we deviated and kicked it up a notch on the tree?
Needs more branches.
No, it does. It needs more branches.
Yep.
Why, did somebody say it needs more branches?
Yeah, Mark did.
Yeah.
Now, Todd actually asked a really interesting question.
Todd, I'm so happy to answer any interesting questions.
Have you ever made your own canvas? I'm looking into making a giant canvas, but not sure how cost-effective it would be, and just comparing buying one versus making one.
Okay, so here's the deal. You can actually probably buy cheaper than you can stretch it, but only if you can find it on sales. Like, so if you've got some woodworking skills and you've got some stuff, generally there'll be canvases in really big ones that are, you know, 40 cents on the dollar or 30 cents on the dollar.
Yeah.
And so that's pretty tough to beat on stretching. The problem is trying to save money to get one canvas to stretch it is that you've got to buy the gun that staples it, and you have to buy the special stretcher thing, and then you're going to have to buy a roll of canvas, and then you've got to buy the stretchers and support beams.
Now, let me go back.
And the nail gun to build it. So there's a lot of tools. So if you already had everything, it's cheaper to stretch it, but if you didn't already have anything, it would be better to go to Jerry's Artorama or some large local art venue and see if they have any canvases, big size canvases on sale. You know, Michaels doesn't really carry like giant canvases, so if you, I know you're in it, you're like in Atlanta, so you can get to an art store.
Yeah. So, yeah, what she was saying earlier is that, you know, if you have woodworking skills, you can go in and generally for 40 cents on the dollar buy a broken or damaged canvas that's very large and repair those.
Yep.
And
we do that.
Yeah. So if, you know, and that's great if you're, you know, if you've got some work like that, just, you know, make sure if you're going to resell that, you note any damage repairs you're doing.
But it's just for his house, so.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to keep filling in these branches. Like, I'm just trying to, and I'm always making like crazy little turns. That's the hard part, is practicing those little turns.
Yeah.
And it takes a lot of this to get good at it. You know, watching tutorials is like reading the menu. Painting the painting is like eating the meal.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes we get to a place where we just keep reading the menu, but we forget to eat the meal. And you only get the nutrition for your body if you eat the meal.
That's true.
Right? And you only get the art skills by doing the painting. You know? And you just got to realize that not everybody starts an expert. Everybody can learn a tree. I mean, just seriously, everyone that just keeps being dogged and determined about this does manage to, you know, accomplish this tree.
Yeah.
So for a lot of people right now, they'd be like, oh man, I'm doing so good. And what they don't realize is now here's where we're going to like, we're going to take it up, 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 uppity up.
All right. How we do it?
We're going to get an even smaller brush.
Oh no.
This is now number two shader.
Everyone loves the tree so far, by the way.
Oh good. And we're going to work out even more of these little details. Now you're going to get little fiddly bits.
Oh no.
See how these little fiddles are? And they do everything that their big brother branches do. I'm resting my wrist on the canvas to steady my hand. So how this is effective for me, because I know this is so hard for so many people, and please don't feel alone if it's not easy. This is about that I am loading just the tip of my brush with this very thinned paint, right?
Uh-huh.
So I've added water to it, I've thinned it. You could use this glazing medium. You could use, you know, all kinds of mediums, soft body gel to thin it out, right, and improve the fluidity.
Yeah.
It's just on the tip there of a very sharp, teeny tiny little brush. If I combine that with the arsenal of light pressure, dude, I can branch all day. The other little thing that I do with branches is it's okay to me if the line breaks a little bit because the eye will finish the broken line.
Cool.
Just constantly adding little fiddly bits of branch. See how that starts to make it so much more like an oak?
Oh, yeah.
And that is generally what people are missing in their oaks, even before they put the leaves on them, is the infrastructure.
Ah.
And we're still doing a decorative oak. We're not even doing a realistic oak here, where we'd be trying to like catch sunlight on all these little bends. You're really working an oak tree, you could be there a while. Just see wonderful little twiggly bits. Wiggly bits. You can turn the canvas to improve your angle and control. If you can just be patient and work this part of the painting a lot, you will be taking it up in your own art skill quite a lot.
Now, are you using just the edge of the shader there?
I'm just using the last, like, three hairs. It's like crazy. How little can I use is where I'm at.
Just that last little edge of it, huh?
Yeah, I'm just trying to get this last little edge in here.
Ah, and Wishka and Wishna is painting along with us again today. Or
yay!
Tonight. She's in India, so I think it's tonight for her. Even though it's afternoon for us. You know, and we should post up pictures and link on our Facebook page. I would love to see what you do.
Yeah, I'd
love to see where you're painting, where you live.
There's some beautiful art we have coming that's getting shared with us from India right now. There's some amazing artists, and I'm really, like, wanting to travel there and maybe kind of see the art scene.
Yeah.
You know, what's happening. Also, I want to meet an elephant that paints. See what I'm saying?
I
really need to travel. Plus, I can eat all the food.
Uh-huh. Oh, it's true. And we're a fan of much of it.
Yeah, so that's like, yay, everything there I can actually eat. So, you know, this piece here now is much more about the tree than anything else. If you can see that, how much this is about this tree now.
So Nina has an interesting question.
I have an interesting answer, Nina.
What is the difference between polyethicane blue and phthalo blue green shade and phthalo blue? I'm assuming she means blue shade.
She means red shade.
Red shade.
Green shade, red shade.
Okay.
Red shade is actually a much closer cousin. It's more like a Windsor blue or a ultramarine blue.
Okay.
So it will mix with those kind of purple, reddish undertones. Right? Whereas the green shade works better for actually making greens. One of the ways to remember it is green shade works better to make green.
Mm-hmm.
When you mix it with yellow, than red shade will. Red shade's going to give you some really olive greens. that do some crazy stuff. And if you're looking to do it, it's awesome. And if you're not looking to do it, it's annoying.
Now, how do you make some of those branches look like they're coming forward versus backwards?
It's like when we did Bean Man. Remember how in Bean Man we could make him look like he was doing all these different things in different perspectives?
Yeah.
If you haven't seen that, that's on Facebook. That's a video on Facebook. So sometimes if I curve these lines and the way I curve them and foreshorten them, it'll give the impression that some of them are more forward-facing than others in the curve. If I added highlights to it, this tree would be very dimensional.
Interesting.
But again, the trick here is don't give up. Keep making branches. You need so many little branches. I will probably even stop branching before I should stop branching, if you know what I mean. Because we have lunch. But you could be here just branching away with these little fiddly bits.
Wow. So,
and you can see how we're painting over clouds we painted. We're painting over stuff. But these layers create a depth and reality to our work that's wonderful.
So,
and I keep thinning this paint and loading the tip of the brush. Yes. So.
And Wiksha, I hope I say your name. I'm saying your name right there. It's in India right now. It's 10:30 p.m. Oh, she has 102 fever. I thought it was to say it's 102 degrees outside, so she's taking it home on the mend, resting.
You need to get some hydration.
Watching some videos.
Take care of yourself. And
I thought she was going to say it's 102 out at night, and I was like, well, it sounds like Houston.
India and Houston actually have similar weather.
We do. We're on the same latitude as Cairo, only we're in a swamp instead of a desert.
And then she goes, oh, yeah, that's us. We, too, can have a plant just grow up overnight and take out over the backyard.
Yeah. Take seriously, your back garden is the little shop of horrors.
So you can just see how this tree now is taking on much more of an oak feel. More branches, more oak-tacular it gets. You should even say the words oak-tacular.
Oak-tacular. I have to go find where you're at. Oh, there you are.
I'm just coming over here to fill in this space because it's all quite light over here. And you can see it when you get back from it that the tree is light over here in its branches.
Now, does the medium that you're using add any glossy effect when it's drying?
Read your mediums. Your mediums will always tell you the finish that they're going to create on your paint. They'll say matte gloss or semi-gloss. And they mean it when they say it. But since you're going to varnish at the end anyways...
Yeah.
You know, you're going to be deciding the finish when you varnish.
Yeah.
We've got to really do some more varnish videos. I've got like the simple, like quick and get her done. But we're going to have to show like how to properly do it where the varnish is removable or repairable.
Mm.
Because there's one way to varnish your paintings where the varnish is removable and repairable.
Oh,
show
yeah.
Show you why you would want that. See, I'm just trying to make my tree tree-tacular.
It is.
It's very tree-ish.
So you like that angle brush for doing the...
This is a shader. Yeah, I do. I like the shader for doing little branches. I also like miniature brushes are an excellent little brush for doing that. You know, I'm just trying to make sure that I'm... And I'm seriously, like, I could do this again for another 30 minutes on a finer brush.
Yeah.
It's just there's no end to how fiddly
you can get.
It can all just be so fiddly. And it's fun for it to be fiddly. And right now that's pretty fun, isn't it?
It is.
And how you just keep taking those out and breaking those out and breaking those out. I think one of the things when we all get together, I want to do when I've got everybody, like where I can get to them, I want to do like a branch clinic.
Ooh, that'd be cool.
Wouldn't it be nice?
Yeah.
I feel like that would be a really good thing. All right, I'm going to grab a number 6 bright.
Good.
And I'm going to come underneath my tree with this black. And just at the top of my landscape, make this little black line just at the top. And we have to decide, do we want to add some foliage to our tree, which I do think we want to. I'm going to. You could leave your tree right there, because right now you have a beautiful landscape painting. I'm pulling the black down, but I'm not going to pull it down as far as the blue. I'm going to leave a lot of the blue showing. Same technique as the blue, though.
Now, could you do
two tones of this?
Could you do this painting with, like, reds?
You could do this painting in any color combo you wanted.
Cool.
Right? This idea, this is a real simple, simple idea. You could do this in any color combo that you wanted.
That I'd love to see it in that goldenrod and orange-ish color.
Yeah. The trick is don't just do red and white and black. You'd need to add yellow to create your highlights with the red. Otherwise, you'll have pink all over your painting, and it won't be as strong of a color story.
That's a good point.
So that would be the only thing I'd say. You could do it with purple and white and black. And at green, again, I would be tempted, maybe, to use yellow to create my brighter colors, my lighter colors of green, rather than white, too.
Yeah.
Just on that one. But the blue and white works really well. Blue, white, and gray works really, really well. And I just have to think about what kind of energy, what kind of feeling do you want the piece to have at the end. Right. And right now we're going to just focus on this tree. How are we doing? Okay, we got time. Oh, we got tons of time. Okay. We may not get into Ilurona, the wailing woman, but we've got the tree.
Yeah, I think we got the tree today.
Yeah, we definitely have the tree today. Isn't this gorge?
Mm-hmm.
So right there, right here at this space, you could be like, I am awesome sauce. Photograph it, share it, put it up on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, wherever you want to put it up. Everyone's going to be like, you're so good.
And?
You could stop there. But if you wanted to.
You keep going. So we're gonna say is that in the iCard is the shorter version of this.
With the simpler tree.
And we also have links in there to Big Art Quest and other stuff in the description below. Is that right?
Yeah, that is correct.
So don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share. We're at 280 people in the room with 260 likes. So we're real close to double Sherpaing today.
We're about to double Sherpa. If we get to 300, we'll have a little dance party.
We'll do a little dance party.
So I'm doing these little dabs. I am loading the edge of my brush. You could do this with a 6 or a 4. And I'm just working the corner. This is on the corner of my brush. And I'm just dabbing up and down. If you did the Monet San Giorgio with us, you're like, oh, I got this. The trick here of what I'm doing is I'm not filling it all up.
Gotcha. Now, can you talk about...
I'm not going to make a lollipop. I'm going to leave a lot of my hard branch work showing. But I still have to make some masses of leaves because this is a healthy tree. And it hasn't dropped all of its leaves yet. This is, you can tell from the weather and the color, this is before the leaves fall. Can I what?
Now, can you talk about varnishing?
Yeah.
But, you know, like, do you have to varnish?
Yeah,
why do you
varnish?
What should you varnish with? Can you use
hairspray? I've got a video on, like, how to do it with gloss, medium, and varnish, and that's a simple, simple way of varnishing. And the positive to that is it's a simple product, and it works, and it does seal the painting and protect it. It doesn't work to just add gloss, medium, and varnish to all your paint because this stuff is quite porous and attracts dust. So for the purposes of protecting your painting, you do need to varnish. Gloss, medium, and varnish, if you're not careful about putting it on thin coats, can leave brush strokes in the varnish.
Now, speaking of...
But it is very easy and very forgiving.
Can you also talk about less is more with leaves?
Oh, yes. Less is more with leaves. So here's the deal with the leaves. And already you're kind of seeing this happen. So I remember there was like this art class. It was a landscape plein air class. And the teacher was trying to explain to people what not to do. And she was like, I just don't want to see any lollipops. And lollipops is that symbolic tree. And actually, the first tree I did is kind of based on intentionally doing the lollipop. It's a solid mass, you know, on a branch here. Right? And that's a really fun tree. But when you're trying to paint trees as they are, you need to make room for birds to fly through. Squirrels need to be able to jump branch, 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 branch. That's the lollipop. And sometimes trees are like that. But when you're trying to do an oak, you're going to have to leave a lot of air. A lot of air. And, you know, you want to...
Are you using the side of that brush?
I'm using the corner.
The corner.
Just dabbing up and down, just the corner. And I could switch to a 4 if I wanted a sharper edge. And I'm just dabbing the brush up and down. sometimes the paint is light and dry brushy, and that creates kind of a lightness to the leaves, creates some variance in texture on how they look. This is really a similar technique to what we did in this one here with the girl and the dog, but it's just taking it a little bit further. And I'm gonna just keep talking about trees till I have thousands of people who are like, yeah, trees, I do them, they easy. We're just gonna be so treed out, because you can do this. It just takes a little practice.
Yeah.
It's like faces. Everybody can do a face, it just takes a little practice. Once you understand the principles, once you understand how to do it, you can do it. Create all kinds of wonderful art journaling faces. Super doable, same with trees, super doable. I'm just dashing. And you can see I'm just leaving open spaces. Just be courageous enough to leave some open space on your happy little tree. This wise old oak here.
Yeah.
I've invoked the Bob.
So Meryl's
asking.
He'll join
us in the studio and help us paint.
So Meryl would like to know, does holding the brush in different ways give different effects?
You mean like if I hold it back here or I'm holding it up here? No, but a brush has several strokes. So this brush has a flat stroke. This brush has a line stroke. And then I've got kind of these little dab strokes. And then this brush can do things like this. Dry brush. So every brush has a bunch of stuff it will do depending on the way you've loaded the paint on the brush, how dry it is, your pressure, whether you're on the edge, the corner, or the flat. You know, things that'll be hard to see is like I might turn my brush on occasion because I'll realize I'm out of paint on one corner, but I know I'm well loaded on another. But you can see this is just coming in together. It's still a decorative piece.
Okay.
The decorative nature of it didn't go away, but now it feels very oaky instead of like a maple, doesn't it? And that's kind of wonderful.
So Aaron says, I used a paint on varnish and never will do it again because it pulled the paint off the canvas.
That was not supposed to happen, Aaron. What paint were you painting with? Please tell us all.
Oh, this is very disappointing. Now, you talked about that in the past before, that sometimes a paint on varnish will lift the color underneath.
What it is sometimes the paint underneath did not bind or fix or cure properly. And when you'll see it because varnish will activate the paint and pull it. This is really, so there's nothing wrong with painting with, say, Liquitex Basics or Artist Loft at all. Okay, nothing wrong. They're very easy on your pocketbook. They have a broad complement of colors. They're pretty consistent acrylic paint. But some of the negatives are is that the places that they're, you know, saving money at as a company is that the pigments are not as good and the binders are not as good. And if you over thin that paint, it underbinds like crazy. And so it can lift in your varnish. And I just know from you guys sending picture after picture where that's been an issue, that that's something that happens really easily in student paints.
So maybe you spray varnish on those?
Spray varnish to affix them down first. If you're painting an inexpensive or off-brand paint, my recommendation would be to spray varnish to fix it down first.
So you can still use them, just be aware of the challenges.
Yeah, just look, I've seen artists be brilliant with a number two pencil. Don't let your media stress you out or ever feel bad about what you have to paint with, you know, or choose to paint with. Whatever makes you happy is what you should be using in your art practice.
Yeah. And
just know what its limitations are and how it performs so that you don't get surprised by what goes on in your art studio.
And all grades of your paint should have a good manufacturer backing them, so you can always
complain.
Or just go and ask them questions, because sometimes you can be like, hey, how can I use this? And they'll all have answers for you.
Yeah, this is what I want for you. Whatever companies that you're at, you want a company that has a contact, email, maybe even number, that gets answered.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, believe it or not, Deco and Plaid both have numbers that they actively answer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and they have product support, and they take it very seriously. So I have to respect them as a company. I might not paint with the paint, but I respect it.
Yeah, a lot of these companies do a really good job to help make sure you guys have good experience with it. So,
you know, of course, like Liquitex and Golden have a customer line, and Windsor and Newton, mm-hmm. you know, and you can count on that. But, you know, so does Matisse, and so does Montmartre.
Yeah.
So there's paint different places, Sennelier Acrylic. Lots of good art companies are out there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so do we just love how this is coming out? How that's fleshing it.
Now
it
you're
just
not,
feels very oak-tacular, doesn't it?
Yeah, now I noticed you're being very fairly sparse
I am, because I want kind of more of a bonsai sort of feel where I really see the structure and design. I mean, I worked really hard to get these branches and I want to show them off.
Yeah.
That's what's happening here. I worked hard. I worked so hard. I want to show it off.
You know? Now, do you use a similar palette to your mom?
Yeah, actually. I think we have kind of a family palette. Like, I grew up with that, or that was the paint in the house to play with.
Yeah.
So definitely, definitely, definitely. And then the next trick on this tree.
Yeah.
Is I'm going to take a little black over to my blue. And get a little glazing liquid in there so it's behaving. And I'm going to come add some highlights to the outer edges maybe of some of these little shapes that I put in. I'm going to say my light is coming from that direction.
Now, are you using about the same pressure on all the leaves?
Yeah. It's just kind of a firm dab. I'm going to add a little white into that mix because it's not showing enough. And it needs to show a little. So you might have to add, because phthalo blue is, there you go. See how it's blue now?
Yeah.
That's what I'm going for. You know, sometimes you're going, you'll be like, your brain says, ain't working. Listen to your brain. Your brain on art will tell you stuff that you need to know. You know, it's just good. You're just adding this little blue highlight to this tree. So now this tree has like a pop of color.
A pop.
It's very hot right now.
No.
Very hot. It's like everywhere on Pinterest right now.
If you're just joining us, welcome. And if you
yes,
are,
we have deviated from the original plan, but it was voted on, and you got to show up early to do the votes.
If you're looking for the original painting, it's in the iCard, right?
It's in the iCard. We decided to kick it up a notch.
But we enjoy that you guys have come and joined us today.
Yeah, very much. Thank you. And I'm going to leave this up because it's a different tree, and in some sense becomes a different lesson then, doesn't it?
It does. It's a toy. You just...
becomes a different painting that we can enjoy and show off. And then you could have a couple of these because you could be like, you could have a pair now.
You have tree variations.
You could have tree variations.
Turn this. There was someone thinking of turning this into a cherry tree.
Totally do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Totally, totally do that. No trouble at all.
Now, I'm going to tell you, we're at 289 people and 294 likes, so we are so close to double Sherping up in here.
I'm ready to dance. Hopefully you pick some good music this time. All I got to say. What'd you pick? I'm back in a show hole again. You guys have to bear with me. I'm trying to be funny, but I'm not as funny because really, I'm in detox. Just... I'm like running to the end. I've got between.
Likes. Look at that.
And
right
that's
there.
All I have left
that
on Netflix.
So
it's a panic.
Fast.
What?
We have 301 likes. Just bang.
No. All right. Give me some music.
Give you some music. Get your Sherpa dance on. Now, everybody should put your paintbrush down, get your fingers and toes in the air, and do a little Sherpa dance. It's good to stretch and work out those fingers and toes. And if you guys are just joining us, thank you. Please don't forget to put your picture up on any of our social media sites there for us to see. And don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share. And click that like button so we can see the Sherpa dance some more.
Or John. How do we never have John dancing?
I think.
I just put that in the ether. You can get me later.
There's
you know they all want to see you dance way more than me.
I think the last time we did it, we had like 500 likes. So
right.
it takes
more
to
John don't
me
dance
till
it's 500
keyboard.
Likes. I just wiped my brush, but I didn't take all the paint off of it. I'm thinning it with the glazing medium, and I'm gonna come just add a few of these bright white highlights to some of my clusters of leaves. Not over everything, just some places.
They're warning me. 325 likes.
Get him. Make him dance.
Paint faster, Sherpa. Paint faster.
I guess I better just slow this puppet down. Slow it down. Talk about the meaning and deep roots of trees. Trees are meaningful beings.
Oh, we're having technical difficulties. The stream's going down.
The stream went down. Wait, You should know that we laugh like this a lot in our own lives. We recognize we may not be globally funny, but we amuse ourselves.
At least we have a singular wit.
John finds out things a lot of times, like last bit, like, hey, I think I'm going to paint a leaf today.
Yeah.
Let's paint some leaves. I haven't done that in a while. Where are my leaves? See? Look at this. Doesn't that look gorgeous?
That's so good.
This is a very, very powerful kind of painting style. And I think it's just, again, these are trending and seeing a lot of artwork, a lot of inspiration out there. In this movement. There we go. There is an oak tree. And again, you could be like, I'm done. You could. You could be just like, I'm done. It's good. It's golden. But I still feel like I want a dog and a girl and a balloon.
Okay. Yeah. It seems like it makes sense.
Does it?
Yes.
All right. So I'm going to paint my girl in.
And then
I'm going to put her way over here.
Maybe we'll answer.
So that there's room in the tree.
We'll answer a couple questions after this.
Yeah, answer questions. Just ask me.
I'm just thinking in general. We'll answer after this. We'll answer a couple questions, and then we'll have we already let the other one loose?
Yeah.
It's already loose?
Well, no, you could make it public now if you wanted.
We'll make it public here in just a couple minutes. Okay. As soon as we're done with this.
All right, we'll make it public.
We'll make it public because this is going to take a little
while to
process.
But people know it's there, like it was up and there was a link they could find.
Well, it's got. This is going to have to process for a little while.
Like forever.
So you guys can check out the other one.
And it does that thing where the browser tells you there's an emergency. Yeah. If you don't know what happens is after this is done, then YouTube processes it. And who knows how many live videos YouTube is processing at any given moment. And so it can take a while. And then during that time, it gives you error playback messages and freaks you out. And then if you don't refresh your browser and drop your cookies, sometimes it won't play. It's a whole thing.
Hmm.
It's a whole thing, John.
It's a whole thing.
So I've about, oh gosh, I would give you the exact measurement, but about 4 fingers above the ground, I planted a little head.
A little head.
A little head. And I'm going to come down here and make my little, almost a triangle shape for the chest. That's all I'm doing on the chest. This is a very abstracted figure. Again, now, if you did Bean Man, you're like,
Now you have some knife paintings, don't you, to demonstrate how to use knives?
I do. We could do some more.
Did you do some more of those?
I almost did this in knife. I almost did that painting there in knife. But then I was like, it's just the same painting again. In knife, and I like to change it up. So yeah. We may change it up on, I mean, I'll always ask first if we could change it up or, you know, pop it up or bring it up. All right, so one of the things I'm going to do here is I'm going to come off this line and make a little, this is really interesting. This is about gesture right here. I'm going to curve this line a little bit. See that curve?
Yeah.
And I'm going to come here.
Uh-oh, Blendy just fell down his cage.
he's okay. He's hard. He's, don't worry.
He's fine. He was exploring the upper edges of it and went, whoops.
He was like, blend it down. So that's how I make her feel like she's leaning into the wind. I've switched to a stiffer brush because the other brush was not putting paint on the canvas nicely for me.
Gotcha.
And I wasn't enjoying that. And I wanted to put paint on the canvas more nicely, which I can do by either making it more fluid with water or some other process. So this is how I get that feeling that she's leaning into something. And then I'm just going to flare out a skirt. Super, super simple, isn't that? Super simple.
Super.
Super duper simple. Maybe take advantage of the fact that squirts like it does. Oh, I know what it is. I need more black paint.
Do you?
Black used to be one of those colors that I never went through that fast. But some of these lessons have given me a reason to really kind of get into my black paint. Now I know all about blacks. If you want to know more about black paint.
You have a thing on it.
I have a thing about all the different black paints.
We do. And we almost have 300 people in the room. We've been so close. We've been like at 290, 295, 299, 294, 298. It's like been bouncing right there underneath it, just tempting us. Just tempting.
I'm just defining out, making this look a little nicer, this little skirt. You know, sometimes I get in this sort of like teaching rush and I forget to sort of refine everything that's happening in my space. She doesn't have feet. Her legs, they just go into the earth here. The feet are hidden from our view, and that's okay because our mind will fix that. I made a little ball here, and I'm going to take a little arm back. I like to imagine that whatever this line is, it's on a fulcrum. It has to end at the waist.
Mm-hmm.
That's where my line would have to end. And then the forearm is that same length as the upper arm. And then I'm going to have her counterbalance here with another hand. And I'm going to just give her, just imply some fingers. Not every finger, not everything in her hand. See, just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit is important.
Now, they're saying that they've seen us hit 300. So
no.
I'm looking over here. I'm looking at it. I see like 297, 296. It's so close. We're there. We're just like 299.
Get a really fine line going while John's having his whole little moment here.
Oh, 303. We are definitely Sherpa.
Are we Sherpa?
That. I see that Sherpa-ness.
All right, let me get my line in and then I'll Sherpa up.
All right.
I'm drawing a very fine line with this detail brush. That's going to be the kite. The balloon string. I've added a little hand there.
Uh-huh.
I'm pulling this up, and then I'm going to have a big dance as soon as the balloon is outlined. And the balloon is a nice teardrop shape. And then I'll do a little flange where it ties. All right, am I dancing?
You are definitely.
Give me some beat. 300, we are Sherpa. I got him. He thinks he knows where the camera is, but I know too.
The Sherpa dance.
Sorry. Too much fun.
It's good stuff. We have to dance. You have to get up on your toes.
You have to dance in life, or what are you doing, right?
And if you're at home, don't forget to do the same.
You gotta
get up and dance, too.
And if you can't get up because you're not feeling great and you're in bed, wiggle your nose, wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes.
That's right. You can dance along even if you can't
dance. Defy everything. So I've just painted that straight blue. And I'm gonna come and do a little white and blue. And I'm gonna add just this little pop of color.
Oh, I'm gonna come down there so you can see that little pop of color. Oh, there it is.
Right, to her little dress here. See the pop?
Oh, yeah.
Little pop. And I'm gonna come and just grab a little white and do a nice little highlight on the balloon. I'm just wiping my brush. I'm not rinsing. And then I'm going to come right here and just dab a little bang. And then blow off a little hair that's blowing in the wind. Just a little hair. That's all I have to do there. Do we want the dog?
Oh, yeah. Gotta have a dog.
Gotta have a dog?
Let's do a dog.
Let's do a dog. Maybe this one will be sitting.
Yeah?
It can be different than this dog. Different dog.
Different?
Different dog. So I'm going to create a curved arc line. And then build this sort of triangle. So one side of the triangle is curved. I hear Blendy hissing. What is he all about? I'll stop painting while you're getting him. Well, because I'm still grabbing paint and stuff. Oh. John's like, I hear Blendy having his whole little moment over there going, no! Put a little dog here. Mm-hmm. So this interesting triangle with a curved back is the basis for this dog. Right? And maybe this dog will be looking at the little girl this time. And I'm just going to take a little triangle.
Oh yeah,
off that triangle.
We need to come up with a name for this. For the
yeah,
for
I'm
the
just
public
really
access.
Seriously have to help me name this painting. need a name. You gotta help me.
You're doing okay.
So, all right. So, there's the little dog body. He's more like not the American Staffordshire Terrier, but it's the bully. He's got round face. And we're going to take a little tail. Wag there. Right there at the edge of the tree. There he is, looking at his little girl, making sure everything is okay. And then the last little thing that we could add, if we felt like it, if we wanted to, would be little distant V's. A bird's flying in. Here's a little trick. The smaller the V, the further away the bird is. So there's some birds flying in. Here's our little dog observing this little girl. And we've done an oak tree. We have kicked it up a notch. Oh, he might. Well, that's okay. If he's feeling nervous, it's all right. He likes my hat. Is he good on there though? Okay. There's a lot to grip. I got a chameleon tail in my eye, and he's using my eyelid, which I don't know how to feel about that, as leverage.
There's a blendy on your head.
He's literally gripping a little corner of my eye. There's a blendy.
He's having a day. He's looking around.
Oh, he likes the hats, though. He feels like they're leafy. Also, he enjoys a high perch.
He does.
Now he's just gripping my hat, so he's good. He's my final hat decoration. That's what he is. So how do you guys like your tree? Please name it.
Tell me
what you think. I'll get a picture of this and fix the thumb, post it up. And that way, you guys, when you come on the live, it's a little different than if you come for the play. There's slightly different stories, and you just tell the one you want. I cannot wait to see you guys. I really appreciate you. Remember, you're kind, you're wonderful, you're important, and you're loved. And I want to see you, the easel, really soon.
Love you guys. We'll